Unreal Engine 5 really simplifies the process of adding and using MetaHumans, and Ornatrix for Unreal Engine 5 also simplifies the process of editing the grooms on those MetaHumans. In this tutorial, we will import a MetaHuman into your scene and learn how to edit the hair on it. First thing I will do is I will go to Window and I will open the Quixel Bridge window. In here, you will need to log in initially, but I've already done this myself. And then you go to the MetaHumans tab, and here you have a bunch of preset MetaHumans. You can make your own custom MetaHuman, and it will be available in this My MetaHumans tab, but we will use just one of these stock MetaHumans for the purpose of this tutorial. Once you select a MetaHuman, you have this little download button over here, which you need to click to download the MetaHuman onto your computer. This may take up to half an hour, depending on your internet connection speed. Once you've downloaded it, you have this little checkbox over here, and then once you click on the MetaHuman, you can add it to the scene by pressing this Add button. This will add the asset of this MetaHuman to your current game. You just close out the dialog then and go to the content drawer to find all this directory structure in your content, and in here you can find the MetaHuman which you have just added. So you just select the MetaHuman and drag and drop it into your game. Once you've done that, I will just reset its position to be at the scene origin, so 000, and I will press the F button to focus and orbit around my MetaHuman. Next step is I will go to this select mode over here and choose Ornatrix. It opens up the Ornatrix window, and in here you can find the subcomponents of this MetaHuman actor to which we can add hair. By default, we have hair only on the face subcomponent, but similarly, we can also add it to body, feet, legs, or torso. I'm going to select just the hair subcomponent, press F to focus on this, and as you can see, we can also see the facial hair, the facial fuzz, being displayed. This might be a little bit distracting when you're trying to groom your character, especially just on the head. So what I will do is I will use Shift and click to select all of these different components. I will use Alt click to deselect the hair. I will right click here and choose the Hide option to hide all the grooms that we don't need currently. Then I will select this hair groom over here, and I will toggle this Convert button to change this hair groom from native Unreal hair groom into Ornatrix editable groom. Next, I will click this plus button over here and add an edit guides operator on top of my stack. Depending on the complexity of the hair, this may take a little time because it needs to ground all of the hundreds of thousands of hairs imported from MetaHuman using Ornatrix tools. Once the operator is added, you can go ahead and edit the hair in any way you want. So for example, I can select my comb brush and just start combing the hair until I get the shape that I desire. Again, because there are hundreds of thousands of hairs, this process might be a little bit slow to work interactively. However, as you can see, in my case, it still works pretty okay. So once you've made some changes, you can see that they're all captured inside this edit guides operator that we created. You can see that by toggling this on and off that applies or removes the changes that we've made. However, if you want to increase the performance of brushing, you can brush just a subset of the hairs by adding the filter operator and changing its value to a smaller value. So by default it's 0.5, which means just half of the hairs are displayed. But I can change this to like 0.2 to make sure that I only display 20% of the hairs. And now if I add another edit guides operator on top and I brush it, you can see that the changes are much quicker and more interactive. That's only because we are dealing with 20% of the hair. Once I'm done brushing and I want to apply these changes to the rest of the hair, all I need to do is uncheck this filter button here, and it will disable the filter operator, and then the changes that we made will be applied to the rest of the dense hair on our character. We can make further adjustments to the hair by adding procedural operators, such as the frizz or gravity or something like this. And when we are done editing the hair, we can convert it back to native hair by again toggling this groom button over here. This may take a few minutes, and when it is done, you can see that the hair is converted back into the native Unreal Engine hair. So at this point, this groom can be used without Ornatrix installed. And if you install it back later, you can continue editing the hair without losing any of the procedural data from Ornatrix operators.